With the weather being unpredictable at the moment, maybe the kids under your feet are complaining of boredom. Maybe you're unsure how to entertain them. Damien O'Neill from fundays.ie is back with us this morning with some interesting and fun places for all of the family to visit. Good morning, Damien. Now, you are raving about this first place.
Yeah.
Tell us why. Tell us where it is, first of all.
Okay, so it's Tara's Palace. It's in Powers Court, County Wicklow. Most people know where Powers Court is.
Of course, yeah.
But look, this is a gem that we found just during the week. It's a 22-room miniature palace. To call it a doll's house would be a disservice. So they have recreated and tried to encapsulate the designs from Carton House, Leinster House, and Castletown House. And they've used Irish craftsmen to recreate each individual room. There's actually miniature paintings in it, the furniture, there's a collection. It's not just that. Then within the display, there's also antique furniture from, kids' toys, prams.
All to scale.
All to scale. And also, some of them are life-size, but the display is just amazing. It couldn't. And the beauty of this is there is a small admission charge, but all of the proceeds go to charity.
Oh, very good.
And their children's charity. So I think it's lovely.
You can't argue with that. And €12 in for a family. That's, that's pretty good value. Tarraspalace.ie will give you further details. Let's go to Donegal. We like Donegal.
We love this Donegal.
Show. Yeah.
So right up in the northwest of Donegal, we're talking about Glenveagh National Park and Castles and Gardens. So absolutely beautiful. And the guys up in Glenveagh have a huge program on in August where every single day there's going to be something going on. It may be treasure trails, nature walks. There's, golden eagles up there. You can keep your eye out. You may even spot one. But I mean, when you look at the photographs of this place, and it's in our own country, it's absolutely beautiful.
That's the thing. If it was somewhere else, we'd be raving about
it. Exactly. Yeah, it looks like somewhere in the Nordics or somewhere.
Dragging people to go along.
Gorgeous.
And plenty of accommodation nearby, is there?
Yeah, there's tons of accommodation nearby. And the one thing I would say is there's a small charge in for the castle, and because it's guided, and there's a shuttle service from the gate to the actual park. So, worth the trip
and well catered to as well.
Yes.
Let's go to Mayo.
Mayo, yeah, the Castlebar, the Country Life Museum. So it's part of the National Museum of Ireland. So based in Turlough House, and or Turlough Park. So inside you've got the exhibitions of how our descendants from the 1800s to the early 20th century would have lived, how they fished, how they hunted, what they wore, the trades, the skills, all of that. It's on display. Again, guided tours available, and also there are walks around. There's lovely
Brilliant.
Gardens and parks to walk through as well. So again, free. All of the National Museums
That's just
are
incredible,
free.
Isn't it?
I mean, go onto the National Museum of Ireland website and have a look. I mean, we've got it all there, and it's free. Most of them are open Tuesday to Sunday and close on Mondays.
All right. Now, as a young fellow, I was very lucky. The Botanic Gardens was my playground.
Yeah.
The gardeners were always very kind, particularly when it came to autumn and apple and peas and all that sort of stuff. You could sometimes help yourself.
Exactly.
If you weren't, if nobody around you, you'd have yourself even more, maybe. But the Botanic Gardens, it's a national treasure. It's much underused.
Yeah, it really is. And again, another free venue to go and visit. And I mean, anybody who's ever been will always remember it. As a great day out, and it's a little bit of everything. You can go and watch, you can learn, you can listen to the various experts that are on there, and they really do engage you, but it's good to know a little bit more than just looking at plants, and just to find out a little bit of what they are and what they look like, and I think it's really good for kids to actually do that and to interact, and it's a great family day.
And there's a lovely cafe there at very reasonable rates as well, which is good. Farmley.
So Farmley, I mean, we
don't need a state car to go into it.
We don't. The state bought Farmley in 1999, 76 acres. It's absolutely beautiful. Again, if you haven't been there, do it. At the northwest side of the Phoenix Park, and absolutely lovely gardens. You can take the guided tour of Farmley House. Most weeks there's something on there. This week they have the Fingal Band, the youth orchestra on the bandstand.
Lovely.
On Sunday afternoon. Please God, we get the weather. That'll be a lovely afternoon.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
Just walking around the sunken gardens, having a look. And, they've got a working farm there as well. So they've carried black cows there. So, yeah, it's lovely to do.
All right, we'll leave it there. Thank you very much for coming in again. Fundays.ie. All of the details are there on the website. And there's loads to do. You no need to be bored. You can get out and about for a while. You'll have a great old day and cost you a little or nothing. All right, we'll take a break. See you back for more R&AM in a few minutes' time.